Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Mario Odyssey. Last time, we made our way here to the Sand Kingdom after defeating Madame Brood at the top of the Cascade Kingdom, and we learned that everything's kind of been frozen over, which is not great, because this is a desert, and as you can see, oh god, this dude owes him money! Dude, I know exactly how you feel, trust me. Alright, and in this episode, we're actually going to do a little bit more exploration of Toast Arena right here. Because we didn't really do too much of it, we just kind of explored this little area right here. So, we're gonna not follow where the Power Moon is right now. We're gonna go this way instead. We're gonna head up this mountain to where we captured that bird at the end of the episode. At the end of the last episode, and we're gonna see what's over here. I already see a music note. And what looks like a bus stop. Are you a bus stop? You look like a bus stop. I don't think we can do anything with him just yet. Let's get this music note. What's gonna happen? Okay, of course. Different music notes around here. So, if we just go ahead and jump from tree to tree, capture these dudes, like so, that gives us, quite simply, a Power Moon. And I believe, actually, this area, a bit- yeah, the Sand Kingdom is the area that was in the in-store demo of this game, because I played it in- I played it in a GameStop a couple times. There's a Lakitu in there. He seems very pleased. He's actually really happy. I played it in a GameStop a couple times, and Zach called it Throw the Cap Jumpy Man, so that was pretty cool. And actually, you know what? We may need to follow the objective, because, again, just like in the Cascade Kingdom, I'm fairly certain most of this stuff is actually cut off to us right now, and we're unable to do most of anything. Because of all this ice, quite clearly. So I think we are just gonna kind of follow the path. I'll stray off a little bit if I see anything interesting, but we're gonna follow the mission right here. Toast Arena Ruins Entrance. All right, I gotta test something. Okay, good. I can spin throw the other way and still move while spin throwing. Good. All right, so let's. As you can see, there's a switch right there. You may be wondering, oh no, I can't get it. But this is Mario Odyssey. Yes, you can hit the switch. And that opens this door. We just did, I guess that's technically a sequence break, because you're doing it out of sequence. They're like, hey, go around. We're not going around, we're going this way. So, let's take a look around, shall we? See what's going on. We've got another 8-bit section right here. And actually, I think we just skipped a whole portion. We did. You know what? I'm not gonna skip it. Oh, I see purple coins there that I missed. I'm not gonna skip all that, because I actually want to show you guys everything, but I also want to just show you that you can skip areas of the game like that. Just by being good at platforming. Alright, cool capture right here. Bullet Bill. We're not going that way though, what are you talking about? Oh god. Oh god, okay. We should have gone that way. Should have gone that way. Yeah, yes, we're sinking. Stop it. Nope, Mario, where are you going? Mario, get up there, please. One thing I actually don't enjoy is that after you wall jump, if you dive onto Cappy, you don't bounce off him. So, you've gotta kinda keep that in mind. Alright, what we're actually gonna do is fly through here as this Bullet Bill. Oh wait, no, there's nothing through here yet. God, I keep forgetting there's a bunch of stuff cut off from us, and it's just kind of a pain. I'm so used to playing this, like, after having everything open to us. Alright, Sand Pillar, but we're not gonna worry about that just yet, because I see a little Power Moon out here that we're gonna go ahead and grab. On the Leaning Pillar. That's 4 already. Not bad, not bad. Hi, Bullet Bill. You come to help me back over? I appreciate it, but we're gonna go this way instead. How's that sound? Ooh, I see. Look at this little dude. It's another one of those, little seeds. You see, we planted one over in the town, and we're gonna go do that again. Can we throw this and, like, make us run a little bit faster? That'd be great. That might be our best option, is to throw this by shaking the Pro Controller, and then roll after it. I think that's the quickest method of movement. Also, I see more purple coins. Alright, gotta grab those before we leave here again. Because, as you know, there was 3 of these over here. That started to grow. You want to place these as you find them. I already know where the last one is, but we're not going to get it for a little bit. What we are going to get, though, is these purple coins, as you can see. Go ahead, Mario. You can bonk. It's fine. You can bonk off of the wall. It's all good, my dude. It is all good. Bowser's footprints. I didn't even see those before, but yes, there's definitely Bowser's footprints on the ground right there. Destroy you tiny, tiny little golden boy Goombas. Alright, let's actually move on with what we're supposed to do now, shall we? Just a little shortcut right there, I don't care. Just gonna take that shortcut. You know what? Platform, Bullet Bill, don't need either of them. Boom, done, easy peasy. And actually, I believe, yeah. Alright, so if we go ahead, We capture a bullet bill. Like so. And then we slowly make our way around here and then go right into this. There's gonna be a power moon. I'll take it. Can you tell that there's a lot? Inside a block is a hard place. Correct. Can you tell there's gonna be a lot of power moons? A lot more than there are in any other Mario game? A lot more than there are power stars in other Mario games? Trust me. If you don't know how many there are in this game, you may have your mind a little bit blown. I would like to get those coins, please. Thank you. You hiding anything? Nope. Alright, let's go in. Into the 8-bit section. And look, if you're in a full costume, like obviously you can change the hat and the outfit individually. If you're in a full costume, then it has its own thing in the 2D sections, which I think is fantastic. Every costume has its own little sprite. And I love it so much. Alright, let's go ahead and break you open. Get yet another power moon. Which is, for some reason, being put over there. But that's fine, I guess. I'll just go grab that real quick. With a long jump and a dive. From a crate in the ruins. Oh god, I just realized it tells you the date I'm recording these. Immersion broken. Immersion completely broken, oh no. God, look at these movement options. I love them. I love navigating in this game, and honestly, that's all you can really ask for in a platformer. If the platformer is fun to move around in, then I think you've pretty much made a good platformer. I mean, obviously it's got other things that need to be good, but if the movement's fun, you're off to a good start. There's also four coins hidden right there, which is pretty neat. I want to not take another hit because then we'll lose our six heart. That'd be great if we didn't do that. So I got bullets, can I duck? That counts as ducking, my hat's just too tall. Alright, and we're just gonna go ahead and jump out of here, grab this checkpoint, and Yahoo! It always plays that cutscene if you collect a story-based moon, so you always know what's going on. Look at that cool dude. That's a cool dude right there. That's a real cool dude. Alright, so, this platform right here is gonna move. And these things we can throw Cappy into. And he gets sent out and grabs coins for us. Which is nice. However, that's not the only thing he can do. If we were to throw him into this one, for example, it hits that and causes a big ol' explosion. And you're gonna wanna do that. You're gonna wanna cause explosions. Usually, explosions are pretty good things to cause. Don't take that as advice in the real world. That was probably terrible advice. But beneath this one is, of course, another moving platform. We can grab these purple coins. And then, I don't think there's any other purple coins hidden right here. I'm actually gonna... Well, no, I'm not gonna skip it. You could skip, like, this entire section if you want to, just by jumping onto the blocks. But just because I don't remember if there's anything hidden under any of these, I'm gonna not do that. It's probably a good idea. Oh, okay. Maybe I should have done that. I probably should have done that. Alright, go ahead and grab those coins for us, Cappy. Again, coins are going to be very important if you want to buy everything in this game. So, definitely get those. They're also important for another reason. Well, not necessarily important for another reason, but they are used for another reason that we'll get to in a little bit. Well, probably not for a little bit, but we'll see. And here we are in Moai Habitat. These right here are Moais. And if you press the Y button, you put on your shades. You walk a lot slower, but you can see invisible platforms. So, that is pretty nice, I gotta say. Also, for some reason, B puts them on as well. As does A. As does X. Everything puts them on. Alright, I believe you can also tell because of these birds, but there is, in fact, another platform right here. You can get over this way, grab these three purples, and then make your way back and grab another Moai. Come here, buddy. Okay. Put those shades on, and as you can see, there's also hidden platforms way up there, and that is where we're going to be making our next destination. Was that English? I think that's how English works. Woohoo! Okay, so birds, thank you for helping us out. We can tell where we're going. Also want to go this way because we checked with the Moai, of course. And that is, in fact, a place we can go. Boom, another one. But we are not quite going to grab the rest of these small pieces of the moon yet. You know why we're not going to do that? Because I've just seen something that I want to knock out right now. And that's gonna be this way! Oh god, are we gonna make it? Easy peasy. Okay, so if we go over this way, up here, I do believe, is our third and final seed. So we're gonna go ahead and take this back right now because I'll forget about it otherwise. And if we bring it back right now, we can have it growing and it will grow into whatever we need it to grow into a little bit later. We don't know what it's going to be, of course. There's clearly no... There's no clear thing that it could be, you know? There's absolutely no way for us to know what these three things are going to be in any way, shape, or form. At all. Ever. There's no way. I bet you have no idea. God damn it. Pick that up, Mario, and throw it. Yeah, you do run a little bit slow with these things, but trust me, there is a faster way of getting around that I'll show you after we plant this one. Boom. That's all three of them growing. If we press minus, we can- Oh, you can select any checkpoint flag you've activated and then press A to fly straight to it. So Cappy's gonna tell us for me. You can do that. So we're gonna do that just to get back over to the Moai habitat so we don't have to, like, traverse our way back over there. And boom, we're here. That's what the checkpoint flags are used for, if you were wondering, because we really haven't used them for anything just yet. Of course, if you fall off, you'll go back to whichever the last one was that you got. But that's pretty much their only other use. There's another moon piece, and there's gonna be one left, which is right over there. Excuse me, Mr. Moai. I'm gonna, just avoid you real quick. Oh, and also something I want to show you. In the action guide, in the capture section, capture actions, there's different- everything that you can capture is put in here. If you want to complete this, you have to capture everything, which I figured is kind of a given. We're of course going to be going for that, and capturing everything that we come across. And there we go! And that gives us a regular-ass Power Moon! It's just like collecting Silver Stars in the Mario Galaxy games. Or in Mario 64 DS, actually, thinking about it. I forgot they were in that game. Boom! Mario was looking hella stylish in that outfit. We have our next destination. I don't know why Bowser's just chilling up there, like waiting for us to come over and fight him, but he is. And in fact, we can capture this little dude. And it lets us take a look around. We can zoom in with Y. There he is. There's Bowsy. That's what we're gonna be going to. It looks like there's a 2D section right there. And you can just see this whole area. This kingdom is huge, and I honestly love it. I think this kingdom's great. There's just so much to it. Like, it's this huge open space, and there's just a lot going on. Well, not right now, but there will be. Once we get to a certain point, once we beat the story missions, there's gonna be a hell of a lot more going on. Get that. Toast Arena Northwest Reaches. We can open this door, and inside we are gonna find a room. Isn't that nice? So, this is like a little challenge room, basically, and in any of these rooms you go into, there's always gonna be two Power Moons. Now I don't actually remember where one of them is, but I'm gonna hope I can find it, because I remember looking around for a very long time in this room. This secret room specifically, I remember it taking me for- Oh god! Okay, that's instant death. I remember it taking me forever to find the second Power Moon. There you go. That's what coins are used for. If you die, you lose 10. That's it. Even if you only have 10 left, or less than 10, even if you have 0 left, it doesn't make a difference. Like, if you have 0 left and you die, you just come back with 0 coins. That's about it. Oh god, oh god, I needed to get another one. Okay. Maybe this isn't the one I'm thinking of. Maybe this isn't the room with the, did we only lose 7 that time? Well, we probably collected 3. This might not be the room that I spent forever searching in then. I think I was looking for some purple coins and this is where I thought they were or something like that. Maybe. I legitimately do not remember. Okay, we're gonna go this way. Oh! I'm gonna refresh the bullet bill because they disappear after a time. But if we go around this way, speed it up a little bit. Come on. Okay. Bonk him, get this Power Moon. The Bullet Bill Maze Side Path. Alright, yeah, that definitely sounds like a secondary moon. There's also something else really cool you can do in here that I want to show you in a second. Can we do it here? We might be able to. If we do this, no? Let me try a triple jump. 2, 3, no? I want to try this. There is something really neat you can do in here. Oh, there we go. You can actually get up on the side of this area and just kind of skip it. You don't even have to use the bullet bills. You know, they really thought of everything in this game. Like, the reason I say they thought of everything is in some areas, I think on one of these upper areas, There's just like a bundle of coins. So it's like they knew that you were gonna do this. So, yeah. Breakthrough, there you go. We may not even need to go up and get the story mission just to move along, but I mean, we're gonna do it anyway. But still, we're now on top of this thing. There's a little scarecrow looking dude in there that we can't quite do anything with just yet. But if we go down this way, there's gonna be three more purple coins. We're almost halfway there on the purple coins. And actually, I believe... See how this area is just like elevated? Like you can hang off the side here. Somewhere in this area, I forget where it is, but there's like three purple coins hanging off the side. And they took me so long to find on my first run through. I think that's like the three of the purple coins that I actually had to look up. Like I tried to do this game 100% blind, but after a while it was like, I'm gonna look some of this up. And I'm fairly certain that's one of the things that I had to look up. But I don't remember where they are. They might be way down at the bottom, actually, thinking about it. But that's okay, we'll get to them eventually. We're definitely gonna grab everything in this game. Ooh, I see a thing right here, though. I see a little glowy spot. Guess what? Can we not do anything with it yet? Wait, really? Hold on. I could have sworn... Am I going crazy? I think I'm going crazy. There's definitely something here, maybe we just can't do it yet. I'm fairly certain that you can capture that cactus. I just don't remember how you do it, so we're gonna leave it for right now. Who? Is that a dead bird? Oh, it's a lizard. He's just chilling there. Oh, three more purple boys. I'll take those. Screw it. Alright, folks. I think from the top of this little tower right here is where we're he got little cactus pins in his nose. That looks really painful, Mario. I'm sorry. I think that is gonna go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Mario Odyssey. Oh, there's a Sphinx guy over there. In the next episode, we're actually going to change outfit, because I promised we would do that in... Well, I promised I would try to do that in every episode. At least for the beginning of the game. We're going to go ahead and do that, and then make our way inside that giant inverted pyramid, and see just what is waiting for us. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.